So let's get into the question. Before starting the question, first of all, what you have to do is read the requirement. So if you read the requirement, when you are reading the scenario, you'll be able to connect the dots easily because you have read the requirement, right? So when you are reading the scenario, you'll be able to realize, okay, these are the areas which is coming under the requirements that they have asked for. So let's read the requirement first. Calculate the cost and benefits of each option 1 and 2 and comment on finding. And discuss certain reasons that they are telling the service offered by the factoring company. Discuss three factors which will determine the level of company's investment in working capital. So let's read the scenario. Before reading the scenario, I want to tell you something. Don't just read the scenario. There are lots of students who will read the scenario for the sake of reading it. Don't do that. If you do like that, you will waste time. When you are reading the scenario, read it with the proper understanding. Yes, it might take 1 minute additional, 1.5 minutes, no problem. Read with the proper understanding, read it slowly. Once you get the understanding, you will be able to do the question fast. So actually you are saving some time. So this is a small trick for you. So let's go to the question. Oscar company designs and produces tracking devices. The company is managed by its four founders who lack business administration skills. So when you are reading the question, please make sure to note down the important notes. So in your exam, you have the scratch pad. In the scratch pad, you can note down the important notes. But now what I am going to do is I am going to highlight the important notes. The company has revenue of 28 million and all sales are on 30 days credit. Its major customers are large multinational car manufacturing companies and are often late in paying their invoices. Oscar company is rapidly growing company and revenue has doubled in the last 4 years. Oscar company has focused in this time on product development and customer service and managing the trade receivable has been neglected. Oscar company's average trade receivables are currently 5.37 million. So average trade receivable they have given, current value 5.37 million. And bad debt are 2% on credit sales revenue. Partly as a result of poor credit control, the company has suffered a shortage of cash and has recently reached its overdraft limit. So they are facing some problem in the receivables management. So they didn't manage the cash properly. So they have reached to the level of the overdraft, maximum level of the overdraft also. So company is facing some problem actually when it comes to the receivable management. The four founders have spent large amount on time chasing customers for payments. In an attempt to improve the trade receivable management, Oscar company has approached a factoring company. So they have approached a factoring company to manage the receivables. Let's see what's going to happen. The factoring company has offered two possible options. So now we can connect the dots. Here, can you remember we read something, calculate cost and benefits of two options? So now we are going to read the options. So this is how you have to do a calculation. Administration by the factor of Oscar company's invoicing, sales accounting and receivable collection on full recourse basis. So what's the meaning of this full recourse basis? Full recourse means factoring company will not give the cover for the bad debts. They will not give the cover. That's the full recourse. The factor would charge a service fee of 0.5 of credit sales. So there is a service fee of 0.5 of credit sales. Oscar company estimate that this would result in saving of 30,000 per year in administration cost. So what they are telling is, if you proceed with the factoring company, there will be a saving in the administration cost, which is $30,000. Under this agreement, the average trade receivable collection period would be 30 days. So what they are telling is, your average trade receivable period can be reduced to 30 days. So these factoring companies are very good in collecting the receivables. So they will be able to maintain this 30 days credit period. Even though our company has 30 days credit period, what you have to understand is, in this question, what they are telling is, our customers are not making the payments on time. They are not disciplined. So what they are telling is, if we proceed with this factoring company, they will be able to get it for the normal term. So keep that in your mind. Option 2. Administration by the factor of Oscar invoicing, sales in accounting and receivable collection and non-recourse basis. Non-recourse basis means what? Factoring company will take the responsibility of the bad debts. They will give a cover for the bad debts. That's what non-recourse means. The factor would charge a service fee of, they will charge a service fee of 1.5 on credit sales per year. Administration cost saving and average trade receivable collection period will be as option 1. USCA company would require to accept an advance of 80% of credit sale when invoices are raised at an interest rate of 9% per annum. So what they are telling is, if they are going for this non-recourse option, it is a condition for us to take the 80% of the credit sale from the factoring company. So here see, the USCA company pays interest on overdraft on 7% per year and company operates 365. Now you can understand, we can get the normal whatever the loan or the overdraft at the rate of 7%, but for the factoring company, if you are taking 80% of the cash that we want, that 80% is subject to a 9% interest. So the interest is little high. So if you want to go ahead with the non-recourse option, then you have to pay that additional interest. So let's do a proper analysis and see which one is the better option for you. So as the requirement, calculate the cost and benefit of each option and option 1 and option 2 and comment on your findings. This question is there for 8 marks. So let's start to do the calculation. A. So let's see what's the cost is going to be there or benefit is going to be there under option 1. So what is my current receivables? My current receivable is 5,370,000. So what they're telling is, if we proceed with this factoring company, according to option 1, our receivable days can be reduced to 30 days. So before moving into that, I want to tell you something. We have to calculate and see, just see guys, what is our current receivable days? Current receivable days. So how to calculate the receivable days? You know the formula. Receivables, which is 5.37 divided by the credit sales 28 million into 365. So here you can see guys, your current receivable days are how much? 70 days. So let me reduce the number of decimal places. Current receivable days are how much? 70 days. Even though you are requesting your customers to make the payment within 30 days, they are not making the payment within 30 days. They are taking how many days? 70 days. You know, when your receivable days increases, your working capital increases, then the amount of the interest that you will have to pay also will increase. And here see, what they are telling is, if we proceed with this factoring company, we can reduce it for 30 days. So if we can reduce the 70 days into 30 days, that's a big saving for you, right? So let's see what will be my revised receivables. My revised receivables will be how much? I'll write it here just for you to get an understanding. Normally receivable days will be calculated, the receivable value divided by the credit sales value into 365. Here what we are going to find is the receivable value. So the receivable value will be equals your receivable days into credit sales divided by 365. So we are going to find the receivable value. No, in your exam you are not required to type like this. Why I type this here? Because for you all to get an understanding. So let's calculate the revised receivable. My new receivable days are going to be 30 days into my credit sales value is how much? 28 million. 28 million divided by 365. So my new receivable balance will be how much? 2,300,370. So what is the reduction in the receivable? So reduction in the receivable. So reduction in the receivable is how much guys? This amount minus this amount. So So previously your receivable was 5.3 million 70 thousand. Now it is 2.3 million 1370. So your receivable balance has been reduced. So you know receivable is an element of the working capital. When receivable reduces, the working capital amount will reduce. If working capital amount reduces, there will be a reduction in your interest payments as well. So let's see what is the interest saving for the reduction in the receivable. Interest saving. So how much is that you are getting here? This amount into you are currently paying an interest of 7%. So that 7% will be saved. That 7% will be saved. So this is the saving in the interest. So what else I have to calculate? I will take it for the row number 7. And if I proceed with this factoring company, what will happen? I will get a saving in my administration cost. So admin cost saving will be how much? It will be 30,000. So here let me calculate the total saving. Total saving. So here my total saving is how much? This amount plus this amount. So my total saving is 244,804. So you have to get this facility, you know. They won't give it for free of charge, you know. They will be charging a service charge. So there is a cost involved. If you proceed with the factoring company, there is a saving of 244,804. That's correct. But you can't get it for free of charge, you know. You have to pay an amount. What's the fee that they are charging? They are charging a 0.5% on credit sales revenue. So what's the service fee? Service fee 0.5% of credit sales. So your credit sales are 28 million into 0.5% of that. Let me take negative 0.5%, then the number will be a negative value. So your service fee will be this. So what is your net benefit? Your net benefit, if you give your receivable collection process here, see, invoicing, sales accounting and receivable collection, if you give the task to this particular factoring company, what's the net benefit that you will get? According to the option 1, 104,804. This is full recourse basis. That means factoring company is not giving the cover, not giving the cover for the bad debt. So your option 1 saving is how much? 104,804. So now let's see what will be the cost under option 2. Cost and the benefit under option 2. So under option 2, what they are telling is it's non-recourse. That means you are getting a cover for bad debts, and they are charging a service fee of 1.5. 80% of the whatever the amount that we are going to finance should be financed from this factoring company at a rate of 9%. So, and what they are telling, whatever the saving that you got in the administration, you will get for the option 2 as well. So let me take this value. Interest saving will be the same. Interest saving, so it will be how much? $214,804. And your admin cost saving also same, which is 30,000. But there is an additional saving which is coming in. What's the additional saving? Is your bad debt saving. Why is that? This is a non-recourse basis. That means they are giving the cover for the bad debts. So in this question, what they are telling is normally 2% of credit sales are becoming bad debts. Now we can save it actually. So 28 million into 2%. So the total benefit that you are getting is how much? So this is my total savings. So now let's see the cost. So what are the costs that you will have to incur? One is the service fee. So let me calculate the service fees. So service fees will be how much? If you are going for this non-recourse basis, it is 1.5%. 28 million into 1.5%. So your service fee will be how much? 420,000. And apart from that, what you have to understand is what they are telling is, now this is your new receivable, no? Revised receivable. This receivable, if you are proceeding with the option one, which is full recourse basis, you can get this amount for an interest rate of 7%, because there is no condition like you should obtain the finance from the factoring company, no? If you proceed with option one, this 2,301,370 is an element of working capital. Working capital element should be financed. So how you can finance it? Using 7% you can finance it. Now what's happening? 80% of this cannot be financed under 7%. You have to finance it using how much? 9%. So there is an additional cost. You had the opportunity of financing 7%, but now that opportunity is not there because you are proceeding with the non-recourse basis. So 80% of these funds should be financed through 9%. That means you are going to pay additional 2% as an interest. So guys, let's calculate that cost. Additional interest. So of this particular amount, which is 2,301,370, look at the formulas properly. I am doing it very slowly for you all to get a better understanding. That into 80%. So this 80% amount, which is, I am getting 1,841,096. This amount, I can't get that amount using the 7%. I have to take it under 9%. So that additional 2% is an additional cost for me. So let's see what's the additional 2% amount is into 2%. So my additional cost is how much? 36,882. So let's calculate the total cost now here. Total cost. So let me multiply from minus 1 to get a negative value cost, no guys. So this is my total cost. So let me reduce the decimal numbers. So what's the net benefit that I am getting? Net benefit, this amount is the benefit, this is the cost. So my net benefit is how much? Net benefit is 347,982. So here, according to the option 1, benefit is 104,804. According to the option 2, the benefit is 347,982. So what they are asking is here, calculate the cost and the benefit of each option and comment on the finding. So you can comment like this. Option 1 and option 2, both the options are good, because you are getting a net benefit. But option 2 is giving you a higher benefit than option A. So it is recommended to proceed with option 2. So this is how you have to give your comment for this question. So now you can see how easy this question is. If you know how to do the calculation, if you have practice questions, you can do these type of questions very easily. So what I want to tell you is, practice questions. Practicing question is the key for success. Practice lots of questions, then you will be able to pass this financial management paper easily. I have done a comprehensive revision for ACCA Financial Management FM or F9 syllabus for a very reasonable price. You can purchase this revision through the link available in the description. In this revision program, I have covered 120 plus MCQ type questions and 6 constructed questions. For each question, I have given you detailed answers and I have provided some additional learning as well. So I hope this revision program will be useful for you in order to pass your exam. If you like my video, don't forget to like it, share it, and make sure to subscribe my channel.